Hello everyone, good morning to one and all. Today our topic is cloud computing over the internet. First of all, we want to learn, let we start basics of cloud computing. Exactly what is a cloud? Cloud is nothing but it is widely distributed. It is purely network based and storage, and it is a computation with the help of cloud to store data. What is cloud in the sense? Using someone else server to host and to process or to store data. Okay, that is nothing but cloud. Now we see what is a internet cloud, exactly what it does in the sense. Let me explain clearly. The figure shows the virtualized resources from data centers to form an internet cloud and provisioned with the hardware, software, storage, a network and services for paid users to run their applications. Here user submit request the cloud paid services to the user. Here let me explain clearly. We are using tablets, laptops and mobile phones. These are all electronic equipments. With the help of these equipments you are accessing the cloud. This is an internet, okay, or computer network. So whenever you are using accessing tablets, laptops, mobile phones, if you want to access any information to store any information, if you want to open your first of all mail ID, whenever you are using your username and password, automatically with the help of username and password your link is connected with the cloud. Okay, your link is connected to the cloud. Here with the cloud and retrieve the data wherever you store server, someone else's server to host or to process data. Suppose you want to take a Gmail in the Microsoft server, you are storing everything, the data related to Gmail. Gmail will store it in the server with the help of these Microsoft app. You are storing with the help of that server, you are storing files or documents or even pictures, whatever it may be, in that someone else server to host to process data. So this is the cloud providers. We are having some cloud providers here. This internet cloud will accessing the cloud providers. What will accessing the cloud providers? Or cloud providers are nothing but the persons who are giving the servers means to accessing, storing and for retrieving. So those are the cloud providers. Here the cloud providers is nothing ma. Cloud providers are different people like Amazon people, Microsoft people, Google. So different cloud providers are there. They are holding some servers. So in that servers, the customer or user relevant information will be stored on that server. So with the help of cloud providers, you want to access different servers. Different service models like software as a service, or if you want to access platform as a service, or else you can access infrastructure as a service. These are all the services provided by the cloud providers to the customers or users. These customers want to access the software as a service like OS applications. They want to be some softwares to be downloaded with the help of cloud to store it. Okay, they want to be used like a platform as a service, means the platform like install the Java or anything with the help of the directly they want to download from the net. They are just asking the cloud provider those software they want to be freely downloaded, or by paying by paying on demand. Okay. With the help of cloud provider, they are asking platform as a service and infrastructure as a service by the customers or the users. Okay, this is the cloud internet cloud, how it will be interacted with the cloud providers and what are the services included in that one. Okay, this is the concept. And coming to the what exactly cloud computing. Cloud computing is nothing but internet cloud we want to accessing or storing or managing data or applications from servers via internet. It is nothing but cloud computing. Here it is the delivery of on-demand computing services. What we have to computing to manage or process communication, it includes both software and hardware equipment or development services over the internet on a pay as you go basis. Okay, for example, if you have to take Gmail, Hotmail and Yahoo Mail, so just log on into web email accounts remotely. Your account does not exist on your computer, so the software and storage for your account does not exist on your computer. So whenever you are log on into the web email account remotely, your related softwares or the storages for your account does not exist on your computer. It's on the services computer cloud. It's everything present on services computer cloud. It is nothing but cloud computing. Okay, we see what's the cloud computing in a clear cut way, what it's efficiently, essentially important points here. It is a cloud, is a pool of virtualized computer resources. A cloud can host a variety of different workloads, including batch style backend jobs and interactive and one more user facing applications. Here, the cloud supports redundant, self-recovering and highly it should be scaled the programming models that allow workloads to recover from many unavoidable hardware or software failures. Okay, this is nothing but cloud computing. And coming to the internet clouds, what we want to say internet clouds, exactly what is internet clouds? Here cloud computing applies a virtualized platform with elastic resources on demand by provisioning hardware, software and data sets dynamically. Okay, here what that means in the sense, the idea is to move desktop computing to a service oriented platform using server clusters and huge databases at data centers. Data centers is nothing but a cloud. Here what we want to say in the sense, cloud computing leverages its low cost and simplicity to benefit both users and providers. Mission virtualization has enabled such cost effectiveness. Cloud computing, it intends to satisfy many user applications simultaneously. Here the cloud ecosystem, it must be designed to be secured and trustworthy and dependable. Some computer users think of the cloud it as a centralized resource pool. It is a centralized in the sense single, under the single authority, it controls only one organization. Okay, it's a resource pool cloud. Okay, others consider the cloud to be a server cluster which practices the distributed computing overall all the servers used. Here the virtualized resources from data centers to form an internet cloud and provisioned with hardware or software, storage and network and services for paid users to run their applications. Okay, that is nothing but internet cloud. This is the brief discussion of this diagram. Okay, already we explained this diagram. Okay, here we want to see from data centers to form an internet cloud and provisioned with hardware, software, storage, network and services for paid users to run their applications. And coming to the cloud, the cloud landscape. Cloud landscape. What is the meaning of the cloud landscape? Traditional, we want to discuss here. Traditional systems have encountered several performances like bottlenecks. Bottlenecks, constant system maintenance and poor utilization and enhancing cost associated with both hardware and software upgrades. It means what we want to say in the sense, traditionally a distributed computing system tends to be owned and operated by an autonomous administrative domain for on-premises computing needs. In the sense, autonomous is nothing but independent autonomous administrative domain for on-premises cloud computing, what the client needs. However, these traditional systems, it's have encountered several performance bottlenecks like constant system maintenance, the utilization will be poor, and enhancing the cost will be effective associated with both hardware and software upgrades. And coming to the one more point, what exactly we want to say, cloud computing, it is the delivery of on-demand computing services over the internet on a pay-as-you-go basis. Okay, here the cloud computing as an on-demand computing services paradigm, in the sense some patterns, it to resolves or relieves from these problems. Okay, that is nothing but the cloud landscape. We have three cloud service models in a cloud landscape of major providers here. Okay, let us discuss. First one is infrastructure as a service. What does it exactly means? Infrastructure. You know, infrastructure as a service. This model puts together infrastructure demanded by users, namely like servers, storage, network, and the data center fabric. It means the user can deploy and run on multiple virtual machines running guest operating system on specific applications. Okay, here the user does not manage or control the underlying cloud infrastructure but can specify when to request and release the needed resources. What does it exactly means in the sense? I will say, listen carefully. Infrastructure as a service, it is a cloud computing. It offering in which a vendor or customer or user provides you, a vendor in the sense one person, another person. The vendor provides users to access to computing resources such as servers, storage and networking. Okay, organizations use their own platforms and applications within a server provider's infrastructures. First of all, you have to put one industry, you have software and one platform and infrastructure. Okay, that is nothing but what we want to develop in an organization. You have your own platform and application or OS in the sense of some software as a service. Within a service, we have some providers infrastructure. What are the key features included in infrastructure as a service here in the sense? Instead of purchasing hardware outright, users pay for infrastructure as a service on demand. And one more point, infrastructure is a scalable depending on processing and whatever the user storage needs. Okay, and it saves enterprises the cost of buying and maintaining their own hardware, because data is on the cloud. There can be no single point of failure. Okay, here it enables the virtualization of administrative tasks. Here one more point, freeing up time for other work. It's nothing but infrastructure as a service. And coming to the one more key point, you have platform as a service, like Java we have to install it. Okay, like in companies also what we have to do. Here this model enables the user to deploy user built applications onto a virtualized cloud platform. In the sense, platform as a service, it is a cloud computing offering that provides users with a cloud environment in which they can develop, manage and delivering applications. In addition to storage and other computing resources, users are able to use a suite of pre-built tools to develop, customize and test their own applications. Okay, here the platform as a service includes, you have middleware, okay, middleware, collection of software is nothing but middleware, databases, we want to collection of some storing, some records, we want to development some tools and some runtime support such as web services like 2.0 web services and Java. Okay, what are the key features in platform as a service? In the sense, it provides a platform with the tools to test, to develop and host applications in the same environment. Okay, it enables organizations to focus on development without having to worry about underlying infrastructures. It provides managed security and operating systems, server software and backups. And one more last point here, it facilitates collaborative work even if teams work remotely. Okay, it is nothing but platform as a service. And coming to the finally, what we want to discuss here, software as a service. Further video, we have to discuss software as a service.